Ejafo ekɔ asetena ne no ene dom kuma no ene dom dodo ni nyada adwen akɔbenkrom akyerɛmu sɛ sɛdeɛ timamfoɔ a ɔmɔwɔ atifido atɔyɛ mandemu ɛno ɛyɛ wano na yakɔ akɔdi ɔmɔ abridia brada asafo no ɛsɛ yetimi hwɛ ne yedi ye etu ye na bambo ekɔ so ɛno ɛntine bɛyɛ a ankempenifoɔ ɔmɔ ahye bɛdwa mu no hwɛ power bɛdwaku a ɔmɛyɛ hwehwemu na yama bambo akɔ so ɛde ama yɛ nyina Massimajafo, as it's Nemo, our modern Junigana Hono, and a Dumkuma Bano Denny, when we young for Runa Drisu, and the two judges say, I uncle far a da a sraf for it to memo for and terminal a year abaform. If we send and say a sraf for no tabo to memo for nipa, say I'm sure I'm come as some a maniama and ya, a bemo of may assume geno at our pay.
There appear to be a worrying development in the country which borders on the safety and security of Ghanaian citizens, largely led by men in uniform, the Ghana Armed Forces. We have not put a draft behind us yet. We know that there were some excesses there that resulted in loss of life following the death of Ibrahim Kaka. And then, Mr. Speaker, only yesterday, as I watched some developments in Wa, a very peaceful city in our country, and there is indication that military-civil relations is at its lowest ebb, and the undermine is led by men and women of the Ghana Armed Forces. And you could see men of the Ghana Armed Forces beating and humiliating Ghanaian civilians. The rights and freedoms of those Ghanaians are guaranteed under the 1992 Constitution. Whatever grievances every member of the Ghana Armed Forces has, we are a country governed by law. They cannot continue to take the laws into their hands. We will not accept a state of normlessness in this country, a state of lawlessness led by men in uniform. Mr. Speaker, what is important is that it is not just for those who were beaten. I understand that one person got his leg fractured and many have been hospitalized. Many have been injured.
Okasa wie ye no eno nmunya fo seche me sabunsu. Edon dodo ba no dani sudan no tumuchire musa eyeno kre.
The leader is telling us about lawlessness that is being led by the military. The statement that he himself made was to the effect that somebody snatched a phone from a man in Mafti. It does appear that that man in Mafti perhaps was a military person, and that attracted the response. As we can, we must admit to ourselves that there's creeping lawlessness. I wouldn't say led by the military, but led by us, civilians, by citizens of this country. Mr. Speaker, and we must own up to that. That increasingly we are seeing symptoms of discipline in society breaking down. And that cannot be happy news for anybody. But I agree with the minority leader that all said and done, the relevant committee, in this case, the Committee on Defense and Interior. I don't know whether we will task the entire committee, but perhaps the committee itself would form a subcommittee within the committee to undertake it because of the urgency of the matter. They may have to visit the scene of the incident.
We NT Achiamehine Abediachiri Awotosumienu Onmunyamfo Joseph Oseusu Abo Asamnuachi.
The Committee on Defense and Interior to proceed to investigate, collect and collate the facts and report to the House within 4 weeks. I so direct.
Yet one seminal soon and